Hi, I'm here with Electronic Beats, and this is my synthesizer favorites. My name is Mathew Jonson, and today I'm going to give you a little bit of an outline of the Korg Trident, one of the lesser-known kind of super poly synthesizers. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. Like my little intro sound there. yeah, this is kind of a weird synthesizer because a lot of the time, you know, you have, in the more traditional sense, you'll have a synthesizer that just kind of has one set of parameters for the whole synthesizer. Whereas this is kind of, I guess, multi-timbral, you could say. It has a synthesizer section, it has a brass section, and it has a string section. And you can mix all these things together. The synthesizer doesn't have MIDI, so it's really just something that you play. And it's a real monster for pads, especially. So I'll kind of just give you a little bit of an outline here. First, we can just listen just to the synthesizer section. I'll turn down the brass and the strings. And here we have a two oscillator synthesizer. And low-pass filter and a basic envelope. It's not a lot of parameters to work with, but because of the SSM filters inside, it really sounds special. Get some pulse width modulation going. One thing I like to do is have the envelope in negative polarity, so you kind of have these rising filter sweeps, which is really nice. You have separate control of the two VCOs as well. So even though it's simple, you know, it is the basic controls of a synthesizer. I can shorten up the envelope here. It's really more for pads, in my opinion. I think you can hear in my synthesizer section, I'm missing one of eight voices. So every once in a while, you'll see one of the keys not trigger in this section. It doesn't matter though, because there are the brass and the synth sections. If we add these to this synthesizer sound, which already sounds nice, I'll kind of put it back in this evolving negative polarity kind of situation. If we come and we add now the brass section, I'll let you just hear the brass section for a sec. Very simple here. One oscillator, basic filter, envelope amount, envelope, and silence note triggers, which allows only certain notes to be played. So if you're kind of doing big like orchestral things, you can set it so that every two notes it plays, or every four notes it plays, or every six notes, which is kind of cool. It does add a lot of character to it, I guess. Again, SSM filters. And you can choose between 16 and 8 feet. Very simple section, actually. Next, we get onto the string part of the synthesizer, which is my favorite. It's like everybody uses the same word for this synthesizer, and they say it's called majestic, and it really is. You have in this section simple envelope, attack, release, an equalizer with high and low EQ. There's a bowing effect with the synthesizer, and it just gives it a bit of a filter effect on the beginning of the note. And I'll demonstrate that for you. You can hear how it's just kind of like, it just feels like bowing, and then. And you can set the tone as to where that kind of bowing sound starts. A little bit like a filter. Then it has a vibrato section. Has a simple filter, no resonance or anything like that. It's just really more like a tone almost. And you can also pick between 16, 8, and 4 feet. And so it makes it really thick because it's an 8-note polyphonic synthesizer, and then you add 16, 8, and 4 feet on top of each note. It gets pretty massive when you think you've got that, plus the brass and the synthesizer section, all with kind of all these different modulation amounts. You know, you've got your vibrato in the string section. You have all these envelopes moving around in the others. When you add them together, it gets really big. Thank you. It's nice too because you have three volumes here for each section, so you can kind of mix in and out of all these different parts. In addition to all of this now, we have a flanger effect, and I think it's one of the best flangers I've ever heard. You can assign it to one of the three sections, and it just adds like a whole another dimension to this synthesizer now. I'll put it on the synthesizer section for now. Actually, right now you're just hearing it just feeding back itself. So now I'll put the strings underneath it here. And then you have a joystick here, which kind of allows you to do trills and vibrato. And when I'm playing this, I a lot of the time I'll play just with one hand, and I'll kind of have my hand just sitting on this thing. Nice because you have intensity that allows you to kind of control how much that is. So a lot of the time you can play it and you just have these little kind of very small bends, which just kind of give this off-kilter kind of character to the whole synthesizer. What I do with this thing. I hope you enjoyed listening to it. It's a hard synthesizer to find that to have it working. If you can find one, it's something really special. See you next time.